Welcome to ISC Plus One History class. We are going to continue with Lesson 3, Economic, Social and Cultural Impact of the British Rule. Before we go through the lesson, we will understand the objectives of the lesson. Impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration. Reform movement, Brahmo Samaj, the Arya Samaj movement and Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Struggle against caste, in which we will discuss the contribution of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru and Varsalingam Kandukuri. Abolition of sati rights, Widowry Marriage Act 1856, Female Infanticide Prevention Act 1870, the Age of Consent Bill 1891 and the impact of this Age of Consent Bill 1891. We had already discussed about the impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration. We had also discussed about Brahmo Samaj. In last session, we had discussed two reform movements, the Arya Samaj movement and Sir Syed Ahmad Khan with his Aligarh movement. And in today's session, basically, we are going to discuss the struggle against caste, those reformers who stood against the caste system in India. Here, we will discuss the contribution of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru and Varisalingam Kanduguri. Before going ahead, we will discuss the new terms of the lesson. Undaunted. Not discouraged by difficulty. Dispossessed. Deprive someone of land, property or other possessions. Ostracize. To refuse to meet or talk to somebody. Prolific. Highly skillful or productive. Harassment. Abusive or insulting other. Loaves and fishes. Tangible benefits, especially when they serve as one's motivation for action. Tyranny, the cruel and unfair use of power by a person or small group to control a country or state. And the last term is downtrodden, the economically and socially backward people. In this session, we are going to discuss those reformers who stood against the caste system. We will start our discussion with the contribution of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule. Mahatma Jyotiba Phule worked for women empowerment and downtrodden people. In area of women empowerment, along with his wife Ramabai Phule, he worked for female education movement, where he set up a girls' school at Pune in 1851. Then for the downtrodden people, he set up school for children of depressed class or the poor section of society. This great man, who was born in 1827 at Pune in a family of malakar or a florist, did a great work for the women empowerment and the poor section of society. So he was given the title of Mahatma in 1888. Jyotiba Phule was harassed by orthodox section of society or the conservative section of society, who did not believe in women education and who did not believe in removing the caste system, but he was very determined and undaunted. He was not afraid of the activities of the conservative section of society. To remove untouchability we had been discussing many times in last sessions, was a practice which was followed in ancient and medieval India, where the upper caste Brahmin used to consider themselves superior. So their wealth and their temples used to be different from the lower caste people. To remove this untouchability, Mahatma Jyotiba Phule started anti-Brahmin movement called as Satyashodhak Samaj. He asked the low caste people to socially ostracize Brahmin, that means socially boycott the Brahmin and stop giving them undue importance. To popularize his Satyashodhak Samaj, Mahatma Jyotiba Phule published two journals. One was Dharma Tritiya Ratna and second was Life of Shivaji. Through his Satyashodhak Samaj, he criticized Congress for ignoring the improvement of oppressed class. This was a time when Congress was in its early year of formation, and the most of the Congress leaders were the early nationalists who were in favor of the British policy. And Congress was basically dominated by upper caste educated, English educated people. So there was no place for the lower caste people. Now we will discuss the contribution of Sri Narayan Guru. He started a reform movement in Kerala. In Kerala, already there was a movement called as Dravidian movement, which was working against caste and creed. Sri Narayan Guru started another movement there called as SNDP or Sri Narayan Dharma Paripalana Yogam. This was a movement started by him specially for the depressed Hindu people of Izawa caste. Sri Narayan Guru also belonged to this caste. Then what we will discuss what were the basic principles of his SNDP or Sri Narayan Dharma Paripalana Yogam. He discarded, Sri Narayan Guru discarded or rejected untouchability. He said that all human beings are born equal and there is no discrimination amongst them by the God. So human being also should not discriminate each other on the basis of casteism. He built temples and he opened all those temples for all the sections of the society. He simplified the Hindu rituals. He said that the shastras, the mantras, and all these are inventions of the pandits because they want to hold monopoly in the society. And what was very interesting that the temples which were set up by Narayan Guru, there were no idols, there were no images of God and goddesses. In place of the images of God and goddesses, they were the images of human being. This reflected his idea that if a person doesn't give equal respect to other human beings, he cannot be a devotee of the God. Like Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru also condemned Congress for neglecting the lot of downtrodden class. It was not that the Congress was against the lower caste people, but the fact was that the Congress at that time didn't have any link with the common people. It was just an organization formed by A.O. Hume that was a link between the British government and the common people. So it was in favor of the British policies, and this was the reason that in the early year of Congress, it was being criticized by social reformers of not taking care of the interest of the oppressed classes, which with the passage of time, Congress adopted the idea of these reformers and took a great measure for the reforming the society and improving the lot of the downtrodden people. Now we will discuss the contribution of Virsalingam Kandukuri. He was born in 1848 and he died in 1919. He started the reform movement in Andhra Pradesh. Virsalingam Kandukuri was called as the prophet of modern Andhra. He finished his matriculation, that is 10th standard examination, in 1869 and started working as a teacher in Korangi town. Virsalingam Kandukuri was inspired by the philosophy of Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar and Keshab Chandra Sen, and especially he was inspired by the ideology of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. So to get inspiration from Raja Ram Mohan Roy's Brahmo Samaj, he set up Brahma Mandir in Andhra Pradesh. Now we will discuss the contribution of Virsalingam Kandukuri. He has contributed in the field of widow remarriage, women education and development of lower caste. In the area of widow remarriage, he said that the widow remarriage was not prohibited by shastras or any Hindu scriptures. He arranged the first remarriage, the widow remarriage, on December 11, 1881 in India. In the area of women education, he founded many schools for girls in Andhra Pradesh. And in the sphere of development of lower caste, he rejected untouchability and he said that equal justice and equal opportunities should be given to all human beings. In this session, we had discussed three reform movements against the caste system. One was started by Mahatma Jyotiba Phule called as Satyashodhak Samaj. Second was SNDP or Sri Narayan Dharma Paripalana Yogam by Sri Narayan Guru. And third, we had discussed the contribution of Virsalingam Kandukuri. Out of these reform movements, Satyashodhak Samaj is having a great importance in the history of India because it has got the patronage of or the official support of Shahu, Shahu was a ruler of Kolhapur and he was against the Brahmin. So it was a more powerful movement because it had the support of the ruler of Kolhapur. The Satyashodhak Samaj was a movement against Mahajans or the Baniya community or the landlords. So it was against the Mahajans and the landlords, the moneylenders and the landlords. I hope you have understood till here. With the help of these notes and the help of the internet, you're advised to make the note of above topic. Thank you.